Now let's talk about this. Is GP Dr. Monah Mansoori. Good to see you, Monah. What do you think?
Well, I think it might be useful for some individuals on a sort of case-by-case basis, but I don't think it's going to be a widespread first port of call. I mean, we have to remember this is a draft guidance. It isn't set in stone as yet. And even if it was a full guidance, it would still need to be looked at on a case-by-case basis, really.
We've had a few messages online from viewers. John on Facebook says, I think it's a great idea. I'm an alcoholic. Been through treatment. It's an addiction. It's also a very tough one to quit, seeing how it's legal in just about every store you go to. The thing is, John obviously was motivated to change his behaviour. This is not a magic pill that's just going to stop you wanting a drink.
Absolutely, that's precisely right. And the whole point is that this medication can't just be prescribed by itself. It needs to be prescribed alongside psychosocial therapy, so other interventions like psychological counselling, that sort of thing as well. So the person who goes on to that treatment also needs to be motivated for them to have any sort of efficacy with this treatment. So it isn't just a case of popping a pill and for things to go away and get better.
£3 a pill, apparently, so £3 a day, seems quite expensive. Do you think it's worth it?
I think for some individuals it will be, but as I say, it's not going to be a widespread thing. It will be something that's likely to be prescribed from alcohol and drug dependency units, specialist units which are geared up to deal with these sorts of problems. I don't think it's necessarily going to be available directly from GPs, certainly not in the first instance, and certainly not until we have more data.
Do you think it would be better to spend that money somewhere else?
Yeah, I think possibly. There's an argument that perhaps the money should be invested in educating people and stopping them from getting to that point in the first place, and also invested more in the sort of psychological aspect, because at the end of the day, you're giving a chemical to somebody that could have side effects. So, you know, why do that if it's not absolutely necessary in all cases? That being said, some people do have very good results with some adjuvant therapy of this sort through the drug and alcohol systems anyway.
I mean, you mentioned before that it has to go hand in hand with other therapies, but isn't there a problem here that the big pharmaceutical companies would like us to be taking pills to control all of our illnesses and our problems?
Absolutely, and this is the sort of constant battle that doctors have on a daily basis. You know, we don't really want to have this culture of a pill for every ill that we've spoken about before. We want people to sort of learn to cope better with things in general and use medication as and where necessary, because at the end of the day, every medication has a potential side effect, and we'd rather not go down that route if we can help it.